Hi friends, you are most welcome to our channel Pharma and Humans. Our today's topic is Reynolds number of fluid and its significance. So in this video we will see what is the Reynolds number, what is its physical significance, what is the formula to calculate Reynolds number, what are the applications of Reynolds number. So all these topics we will discuss in this video. So keep watching this video up to last. If you have not subscribed my channel till now, then please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon. So first of all, we will see what are the types of flow. So there are mainly two types of flow, that is laminar flow and turbulent flow. In laminar flow, the fluid layers travel parallel to each other. They do not intersect with each other. You can see in this picture. Whereas in turbulent flow, the fluid layers travels in a zigzag path and intersect with each other. They do not travel parallel to each other. You can see in this picture. Okay. Now you see what is a Reynolds number. Reynolds number is nothing but it is a ratio of inertial forces to viscous forces, and it is denoted by Re, and it is a dimensionless number. And Reynolds number is used to determine whether this fluid is turbulent flow or laminar flow. Okay, this is the formula to calculate the Reynolds number. Here Reynolds number is given by rho VL divided by mu. Here rho is nothing but the density of the fluid, V is nothing but velocity of the fluid, L is length or diameter of the fluid, and mu is viscosity of the fluid. So from this formula you can see that Reynolds number is directly proportional to the density of the fluid. That means if our fluid has higher density, it has higher Reynolds number. And also Reynolds number is directly proportional to the velocity of the fluid. That means if our fluid has higher velocity, that is our fluid is traveling with higher velocity, then it has higher Reynolds number. If the same fluid is traveling with flowing with small velocity, then it has small Reynolds number. And also it is directly proportional to L, that is length of the pipe or diameter of the pipe. If pipe has higher diameter, then it has higher Reynolds number. If pipe has small diameter, then it has low small Reynolds number. And also it is Reynolds number is inversely proportional to the viscosity of the fluid. That is higher the viscosity of the fluid, then it has lower the Reynolds number. Means for high viscous liquids, Reynolds number will be small. We can take the example of honey. Honey is a viscous, highly viscous liquid, so it has a small Reynolds number. Okay. Now we will see on which type of flow pattern what will be the Reynolds number value. If our Reynolds number value is from 0 to 2300, then our flow is a laminar type of flow. Okay. If our Reynolds number range is in between 2300 to 4000, then our flow is transition type of flow. Okay. If our Reynolds number value is greater than 4000, then we have turbulent type of flow. Okay. We will see how to calculate the Reynolds number with one example. So here one example is that find the Reynolds number if a fluid of viscosity 0.4 Newton per second meter square and relative density of 900 kg per meter cube flowing through a 20 mm pipe with a velocity of 2.5 meter per second. Okay, so here viscosity of the fluid is 0.4 Newton per second per meter square, density of fluid is 900 kg per meter cube, and diameter of the fluid is pipe is 20 mm, that is 20 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter. Okay, so we will put all these values in this formula rho VL divided by mu. So after calculating, we will get 112.5. So we can see that our value is less than 2300. So we can conclude that our flow is a laminar type of flow. Okay, this fluid flowing through pipe has a laminar type of flow. Okay, now we will see what is the effect of Reynolds number on pipe or fluid. If a fluid flowing through pipe has Reynolds number less than 4000, then it causes scale and algae formation on inner wall of the pipe. That means if our fluid is not flowing in turbulent flow, that means it is fluid is flowing in laminar flow, then it causes laminar flow causes algae and bacterial formation inside the pipe or fluid, and also it causes scale formation inside the inner wall of the pipe. Okay, so to avoid this, what we have to do, we have to keep always our fluid in a turbulent flow. Turbulent flow avoid scale formation, algae formation. Okay, this is the reason why pharmaceutical industries prefer turbulent flow of fluid in the pipe. So in pharmaceutical, in all the pharmaceutical industries, processed water flowing through pipe have always velocity greater than 3 meters per second. That means they are using turbulent flow in the pipe. This is the pharmaceutical guidelines that all the water which are flowing through pipe which is used in pharmaceutical process should have always velocity greater than 3 meters per second. Okay, so this is all about the video. I hope you like this video. So please press the like button, subscribe my channel and share this video with your friends. So thanks for watching. Bye bye.